guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Ravisha, and if it's your first time here, let me tell you something about myself. I'm an avid faster, a skincare junkie, fiddling in fitness, absolutely love the fact that the body can heal itself, and I know you just want to know what are the benefits of fasting and intermittent fasting. So keep watching. Human growth hormone, what does it do? Well, as the name suggests, we're born with it and it helps us grow. So it's highest when we're born and eventually with age it declines. But what does this hormone do? It's responsible for protecting the protein in our body. So our muscle, our tendons, our hair, our nails, even our bones for that matter are taken care of by human growth hormone. But with age as it declines, so do all these things. So on average basis, a human being does have spurts of human growth hormone, specifically when they sleep. But during fasting, there's a continuous rise in increase of that hormone. So usually if you do a 5-day fast, you are going to have an increase of about 300% in human growth hormone. And why is that good? Well, this hormone not only protects the proteins, but it is a fat burning hormone. That means when human growth hormone is high, you will burn more fat. It is a repairing hormone. So that means an increase in collagen. So if you have any wound or cut, it will heal. That is why if you see the kids, especially puberty and under, they are usually very fit in spite of eating a lot of junk because of this hormone. They never lose muscles and have a very toned body. And they usually heal at the fastest because of this hormone producing a lot of collagen. Insulin, the most known hormone in the medical fraternity and by common layman as well. What does this do? Well, insulin is not bad. It is the high blood sugar that's bad. So when you have high blood sugars in your body and your insulin is not able to control it or make sure that it's taken care of, that's when you come onto medication. High insulin level causes so many diseases than just diabetes type 2. I will link it here. And if any of these are showing symptoms, that means it's high time you start putting fasting into your regular routine so that you can save yourself from any further complications. PCOS or infertility is such a common thing seen these days in young women. Why? Well, there are a lot of causes. If you see, it's fat, you're obese, there's insulin resistance, high insulin levels, high blood glucose levels, and you put onto a medication like metformin or a drug similar to that. Well, what can fasting do? As I mentioned, fasting will improve your blood glucose levels. Hence, your blood glucose levels are going to come down. Your cysts are going to reduce. Your human growth hormone level will increase and lead to fat loss. So you lose your fat, your insulin levels come down. Basically, your hormones will come into synchrony and you will be able to take care of your PCOS. If you're looking to improve your heart health, fasting is a very good answer for that, to cure yourself naturally. When you're fasting, of course, you have a limited window, you don't eat gunk, so you decrease your levels of bad cholesterol or the LDL. You're not eating that much, so your heart is not pumping that much of blood, so your hypertension is also taken care of. And of course, your resting heart rate. Your heart is relaxed and not overworking by sending too much of blood everywhere. And so your resting heart rate comes down, which is a very good thing. Fatty liver, the most common term that we come across. Fasting can cure fatty liver. Simply because your fat is not responsible for collecting all that fat. It is not where your fat should be. It is supposed to be in your adipose tissue or your fat cells. It's just your bad eating habits that cause it to get accumulated and jamming up your poor liver. So when you start fasting and you get into a fat burning mode, the first place it's going to take fat out from is your liver, because that's where it's not supposed to be. In today's busy life, we all need our brains to be really sharp and focused. But what do we do to take care of that? Well, let's do fasting. What fasting does is it increases neurogenesis. In short, it basically improves your focus and your cognitive skills and saves you from neurodegenerative diseases like Parkinson's and Alzheimer's, tumors, cancer-causing cells, strokes. All of these are something that fasting can take care of. In the year 2016, the Japanese scientist Yoshinori Osumi discovered the phenomena of autophagy and was awarded Nobel Prize for that. But what is autophagy? Autophagy is a phenomena which basically means self-eating. So our bodies are very smartly designed. They can actually identify that which of the cells are dead, diseased, or really bad, your parasite, your yeast, your mold, anything that our body does not want. It's going to consume itself and it's going to dispose it of because it's garbage as per our body, and use that energy to build healthier cells for our heart or brain or wherever our body just needs it. It's going to send away those cells to repair our body. But autophagy is a phenomena which usually activates after your glycogen stores are depleted. So approx 24 hours or plus, depending on what kind of diet you eat. And it goes up to peaks up to 5 days till 7 days. Everybody in these times is having some or the other gut issues. It's SIBO, leaky gut syndrome, constipation, diarrhea, bloating, GERD, reflux, you can name it. But why is this happening? Well, you know why it's happening, right? It's because you had the bad kind of food. You did not give time to body to repair itself. So fasting is what will give your body the time to repair itself. So when you're not eating and fasting and all the points I mentioned, human growth hormone, autophagy, lower insulin levels, these all combined will make sure that they produce healthy cells for your body. So our intestines have this mucosal lining which is supposed to shed itself and form a new one every 5 days. But because of all our wrong habits, this process is hampered and some of the other problems appears. When we do fasting, our body produces those healthy cells to regenerate our intestinal stem cells and form a healthier mucosal lining. So all your allergies, your food allergies are even taken care of if you do fasting, and even to a level makes you a little immune and repair that problem that you have with food allergies. Wrong eating habits cause so much of inflammation in our body. And our day-to-day life also causes a lot of inflammation in our body. Things like arthritis, gout, even inflammations of intestines, all these things. Well, how can we take care of it? Well, I've talked about insulin, but insulin is not the enemy. It is the high blood glucose levels that's the enemy. So when you have hyperglycemia, to simply put, it does not let your white blood cells do its job of bringing down the inflammation in your body. And when your high blood glucose levels come down by fasting, your inflammation also comes down. Well, who doesn't want a crystal clear, glowing and wrinkle-free skin? Well, fasting is where it comes to play. I'll address one in each topic. So if you have acne or psoriasis or rashes or eczema or even a glowless skin, it is very much possible that your gut is going through a really bad time. So we have biomes in our gut and our skin which communicate with each other simply because your skin is your largest organ. So if there are toxins or anything going wrong, it's going to be visible on your skin in some form or the other. So if you have acne or any of these things that I've mentioned, please do fasting. Give your gut the time to heal. If you have those cystic hormonal acne because of PCOD, your fasting process is going to help you put your hormones into synchrony and reduce that fat that you have, which is causing a lot of problem with your liver and other organs. So you need to fast to bring everything into synchrony. A healthier gut is always going to be a beautiful, glowing and clear skin. Also, fasting promotes collagen, like I mentioned, human growth hormone and collagen are together. So when you fast, you have collagen production going on, and higher collagen production means higher skin elasticity, means less wrinkles. So if you want that really beautiful, flawless skin and you look lesser than the age you are, do fast. Weight loss and detoxing are the most important part when it comes to your fasting. Yes, we need to detox. Yes, our bodies are capable enough to detox on a regular basis. But if you're somebody who eats a highly refined sugar carb diet, if you're somebody who drinks a lot, if you're somebody who doesn't exercise and leads a very sedentary life, and if you're somebody who has too many wrong habits to list here, trust me, your body's already overworked and will not be able to do that detoxing that it should be doing. So when you do fast, you relax your body. Your body is able to take out all the toxins, eventually work up its way to give your body a clean slate for a smoother functioning. And losing weight is definitely one of those. When you lose weight, your organs have lesser pressure and are less burdened to work to provide nutrition. You'll be able to absorb nutrition better. You'll be able to function better. You'll be able to focus better, happier and healthier in every way possible. Well, these are the major benefits. And if you've seen and understood, they're all linked to each other. A good heart health, a good brain health, a good skin, a good gut, and a good liver and good kidneys. Everything. We are a really complex machinery working on an unexplainable level. But fasting is something that's naturally into us and can help cure our body and help us live a long, healthy life. So if you really like the video and if you think it is beneficial to you, please, please, please do like, share and subscribe. Leave a comment down below. Share it with anyone who suffers with any ailment and wants to heal themselves naturally. And please keep watching. Namaskar.